Hello everyone, so nice to see you again. I finally defended my PhD thesis, so I'm done with that chapter in my life. And I'll probably make a YouTube video explaining my journey for getting a PhD, so stay tuned if you're interested in that. But until then, I still have some housekeeping to do. Namely, I will attend the ACL 2024 conference in Bangkok this year. I got the paper accepted there, so I need to prepare a 10-minute presentation video for the conference. I thought you might find it interesting as well, so I wanted to share that video with you guys here. And if you find it interesting, do not forget to just ping me at the ACL. See you in Bangkok if you're there. Hello! We are happy to present a new self-consistency measure to evaluate natural language explanations produced by LLMs about their own outputs. Having a model self-explain its own predictions in words seems like an easier and less cumbersome way of studying a model's internal states compared to us interpreting the model with specifically designed interpretability methods. Fortunately, LLMs can produce explanations either post hoc after a prediction or in chain of thought before the final answer. Only that LLMs have answers and explanations that can be unstable, contradictory, and utterly misleading. Models can endorse users' misconceptions, they can generate chain of thought explanations that hide their sensitivity to biasing features such as the answer in chain of thought learning being always A, or being susceptible to user suggestions that say, I think the answer is A, but I'm curious to hear what you think. On the other hand, models can be insensitive to incorrect labels in in-context learning. They can produce correct predictions even with irrelevant and misleading prompts. So either model outputs and explanations can be too sensitive to misleading inputs, only that sometimes they're not sensitive enough to such inputs. So we would like to have a faithful explanation that accurately reflects the true reasoning process of a model, such that for a certain answer and explanation we can determine whether the explanation is faithful or unfaithful. Fortunately, there are tests for faithfulness in the literature. They're either post hoc tests, such as the counterfactual edits test. Here, for a model question, answer, and explanation, the test creates a test instance where it edits the question to introduce extra words, here 1 times in red. The original explanation is deemed unfaithful if the inserted words change the prediction but are not mentioned in the explanation. Unfortunately, the test was applied only to T5-based models and is only as good as one finds such input edits. Unfortunately, training extra models to search for them makes this test more an adversarial attack, finding out-of-distribution edits that change the model's prediction, and this is less an actual faithfulness test. Another test for post-hoc settings is the constructing inputs from explanations test. It takes the explanation and parses it into logical subcomponents to make a test instance where the explanation subcomponents are now part of the question. The test deems the original explanation unfaithful if the model changes its prediction in the test instance. Unfortunately, it only works specifically for datasets where the explanations are templated and easy enough to parse like this. Chain of thought tests are, for example, the following. Biasing features produces a test instance by editing the model input to include something like a user suggestion. It deems the initial explanation unfaithful if the user's opinion influenced chain of thought and prediction, which is not mentioned in the explanation. It was applied to 2 closed models. Corrupting chain of thought edits the chain of thought produced by the LLM in various ways, for example by adding mistakes to it. It judges the LLM to be unfaithful to the chain of thought if it ignores the mistake in the chain of thought. It was applied to an unspecified 175 billion transformer LLM, fine-tuned with RLHF to be a helpful assistant. Judging by the author's affiliation, it is probably a Claude version. But all in all, existing faithfulness tests have several shortcomings. They're either designed for post-hoc or for chain of thought, and post-hoc tests did not test modern LLMs. Some tests work only for specific datasets, but not for any query we might input to the model. Different papers do not apply their tests on the same models and data. And some tests require semantic evaluation of the explanation, which is unsolved. Tests only have binary verdicts but do not deliver a continuous measure of faithfulness to capture that maybe half of the explanation might be faithful. Their verdicts rely on the effect of input editing on the model output, but some models lack the capability to react to such input edits because they basically compare outputs with the input edit and without the edit, without inspecting the model's internals. These tests do not in fact judge a model's faithfulness when generating self-explanations, but rather their self-consistency. And we acknowledge that the road to actual faithfulness is still long, but for now we want a better self-consistency measure that at least does not have the first six shortcomings. So we devise a score for self-consistency called CC-SHAP to measure how much after SHAP interpretation, input contributions for answer prediction and input contributions for its explanation are alike. CC-SHAP is a continuous value between -1 for opposing contributions and 1 for perfect self-consistency. We compute input contributions from Shapley values, and due to time reasons I will not get into the details, but let's mention the main ideas and steps here. We undergo a normalization step to make different SHAP values magnitudes between individual tokens and predictions and explanation comparable. Secondly, we need to aggregate over the many output tokens that autoregressive models produce to have a monolithic input contributions profile to compare to. And unlike all previous tests, CC-SHAP is more than a test. It's a continuous measure of self-consistency instead of delivering binary verdicts. It's interpretable because we have an indication of where answer and explanations use inputs differently. It's applicable to both post-hoc and chain of thought settings. It does not require semantic evaluations of explanations, nor annotated data, nor input edits. And it's applicable even to weaker models like GPT-2 that do not react to input edits. So we get sample-level interpretations and input contribution scores for the model prediction and for the model explanation, and CC-SHAP tells us how much they align. But to evaluate the effectiveness of CC-SHAP, we need a comparative consistency bank, as there is no ground truth for explanation faithfulness possible at the moment. And all previous work does not compare their tests on the same models and data, so the idea is to compare tests to see whether existing self-consistency tests are consistent among themselves. Therefore, we choose 5 tasks for our comparative consistency bank, we evaluate 11 LLMs on it, and we measure their self-consistency with CC-SHAP score and also test the self-consistency with 7 other tests from literature. We find that existing tests show great divergences among each other, especially for GPT-2, where some assign 0% and others 100% self-consistency. Bayes LLMs are less self-consistent than chat models, and we find no trend between size and self-consistency, at least for the size range we could test. So we found that faithfulness tests are in fact self-consistency tests that deliver diverging results, and we proposed a better way to measure self-consistency as it combines input and output level consistency. It does not require input edit, it is interpretable and it's continuous. And we already extended CC-SHAP and the other tests for VLMs, but that is the matter of another paper. We hope that our comparative consistency bank is a valuable resource for the community to, from now on, compare self-consistency and faithfulness tests and measures to have a more unified view of the progress in our field. Thanks for interest in our work. We invite you to read the paper for more details.